We typically sense music through our ears. But what if we could use our skin instead? This vest makes that possible.
It's very hard to translate in words, but once you feel it, you understand it. It's something that hits you right in the core. It's about breaking boundaries.
I felt myself looking around, saying, did you feel that?
I didn't know what to expect, and then it just hits you.
I grew up never thinking that something like this would be possible.
It's creating like a whole new platform for expression being the canvas. The canvas is your skin. We call it the art of haptics.
Hey everyone, we're in Queens today at the Museum of the Moving Image. I'm Steve, I'm the sound guy at Freethink. Sound and music are a huge part of my life and are integral to the way that I express myself. And that's why I'm excited to head in there and experience sound in a way I never have before. Not Impossible Labs is a group of outside-the-box thinkers who use technology to solve seemingly impossible problems for real people. And they're hosting this artist showcase to test out their wearable haptic suits.
What we want to create is an experience that is like pleasurable, it's enjoyable, it doesn't overwhelm you, but at the same time it's very precise and specific.
They had this idea about how to experience a live event by bypassing the ears and going through the skin using vibrations.
Right now we have 24 points of vibration in the system, and they're all individually controllable. We can control frequency and amplitude, but we can make a note stronger or weaker, higher or lower. So you can create amazing movements and rhythm, intensities and frequency variations.
A few years ago, Not Impossible hosted a concert to launch this technology.
We had an audience of 130 hearing people and 70 deaf. They were just like going crazy and having fun with the show, and you couldn't tell. And this was like, wow, a melting experience for us because like this is so beautiful. So we started like realizing inclusivity, it's on the core of the idea of the whole technology. It was not actually something for the deaf. You can have the experience regardless of your hearing level.
Hello, 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 hello.
Daniel created a software platform for artists to easily integrate these haptic suits into their performances.
So what we've been working on, these modules, it's basically like a drag and drop thing, and you can just create, you know, out of the box. The idea was to provide these tools so people could go and do whatever they want, and empowering the deaf community to also be creators and designers for the system.
Tonight's showcase is the first time they've invited other artists to test the limits and push the creativity of this platform.
So it's almost like bypassing the need to use language and just being like, this is how everybody feels. Doesn't matter where you're from, what you speak, here it is.
I've heard a lot of bands and I've seen a lot of shows, but I've never felt one before. At least not like this. And that's why I'm here tonight.
I feel like this was made for a much smaller person. Am I good to go?
Highest setting?
Highest setting.
Okay,
I'm ready.
Cool.
Tonight, we're gonna experience vibrations. Vibrations on certain frequencies. It's so hard to explain. It's just like trying to explain what is blue to a colorblind person because you lack the metaphors, you lack the language, and more than that, you lack the references as an experience to be able to relate. People have to experience in order to understand it. I think it's a whole new language, science-wise and also artistic-wise. The creators are coming from very different angles, and it's very interesting to see different perspectives. And I think that's how the arts evolve, right, as a technique, because for me, technology and art were always combined.
It's not easy trying to create a new form of expression, especially when you're trying to marry technology with art.
It's not just me. Are you guys feeling the vibrations?
No.
Thank you. Can you do press the test? It's bootstrapping a spaceship.
Okay. Everything that broke totally today. So I'm.
Yeah. We don't know if it's gonna get to Mars. It's gonna hit the sun, or if it's gonna crash.
It's perfect.
Yeah. All
right.
Refresh.
Oh. Yeah! Unicorn.
How does it feel to bring these different kinds of people together?
The word that comes to mind right now
it's overjoyed. We had, you know, everything to go wrong, but it was an extremely successful night from all standpoints. I couldn't be happier.
Not all the art was for me, but whether I liked it or not, the vest continuously kept me immersed in the experience. And it's easy to imagine that this could be not only something that changes the way we watch film and go to concerts and experience art, but it has the potential of taking off in ways that we can't even conceive of yet.
It's not just about the experience, it's about the community. Down deep in the core of this whole concept, it's about how we can be humans together.
Thanks for watching our series about the culture of change. I hope it resonates with you like it did for me. For more great stories about people that are challenging the way we think, give us a like and subscribe to Freethink now.